गुड मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स, दिस इज द नेक्स्ट यूनिट, यूनिट नंबर 5th. आफ्टर कंप्लीशन ऑफ दिस 4 यूनिट वी विल स्टार्ट द यूनिट नंबर 5th. द नेम ऑफ दैट यूनिट इज प्रोबेबिलिटी थ्योरी. इन दैट सी हियर फर्स्टली व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ इवेंट. इवेंट मीन्स व्हाट? थ्रोन अ डाइस, दिस इज एग्जाम्पल ऑफ इवेंट. नेक्स्ट, टॉसिंग अ कॉइन, दिस इज ऑल्सो इवेंट. हाउ टू फाइंड द प्रोबेबिलिटी ऑफ दैट इवेंट? द फार्मूला इज दैट शॉर्टली. This is a main formula. Remember that A means what? Event. The probability of event, how can calculate? The number of favorable cases of that event. Number of that favorable cases of that event, A is event, divided by number of that exhaustive number of that event. Exhaustive number means what? Sample space. If you are tossing the coins, what is the possibility? Either head or tail. This is called as a exhaustive number. And favorable cases means what? It's either head or it's either tail. Depends upon our result. This is called as a favorable cases. So we will see the example. This is the main formula. Remember that probability of any event is equal to number of favorable cases divided by sample space. Small m indicates favorable cases, capital N indicates sample space. We'll see the examples, very easy examples. See here example. Find the probability of getting an even number on rolling a die once. See here, dice contain, there are 6 faces. So sample space, that is capital N. It is first face, second face, third face, fourth face, fifth face and sixth face. So sample space is equal to, what is the number? 6. Next, what are you asking? The probability of getting even number. In that, which number is even number? 2 face is even number. 4 face is also even number and 6 face is also even number. Hence, the event is that getting an even number, that is small m. Small m indicates the favorable cases, that is even number, that is that number is 2, 4, 6. What is the number? How many numbers? 3 number, that is 2, 4, 6. This is 3. So, formula is that probability of A means what? Event. What is here event? Thrown a dice is here event. The probability of that event is equal to number of favorable cases divided by exhaustive number or sample space. That is small m divided by capital N. Small m indicates the favorable cases. Capital N indicates the exhaustive number or sample space. So, what is the favorable number? 3. And what is the sample space? 6. So, favorable cases divided by sample space, that is 3 by 6 is equal to 1 by 2. So, probability of that event is 1 by 2. So, we'll see the next example. Find the probability of getting head at least once on tossing two coins simultaneously. Suppose one coin is toss, then its possibility was either head or tail. If tossing two coins, then what is the possibility? That two coin may be head, that two coin may be one time, one coin is head, other coin is tail. Next time, one coin is tail, other coin is head. And last possibility is both coins are the tail. That means what is the sample space? Head, tail. Tail head and tail. That is sample space or exhaustive event is 4. That is capital N is equal to 4. But we required favorable cases. What is the favorable cases? We required at least one head out of from this. So here head means what? At least one head. Head tail means what? At least one head. Tail head means what? At least one head. But there is no heads. Means what? Favorable cases, head, tail head. That is equal to 3. And that number indicates the small m. So, we know that the formula number of variable cases divided by sample space, that is equal to cap small m divided by capital M. Small m indicates variable cases, that is 3, and capital N indicates the sample space, that is here 4. So probability of that event is what here, tossing of 2 coins. It's possible, what is its probability? Number of variable cases by sample space, that is 3 by 4. This is the last answer. Again, we will see some example depends upon this in next lecture.